whole eternity, one God, whose teaching is life, whose presence is sure, and whose love is endless. Amen. Let us confess our sins to the one who welcomes us with an open heart. God, our Comforter, like lost sheep, we have gone astray. We gaze upon abundance and see scarcity. We turn our faces away from injustice and oppression. We exploit the earth with our apathy and greed. Free us. Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Worship continues as we hear now God's holy word for us on the 16th Sunday after Pentecost.
Thanks.
Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And on the way, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And they answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." He asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter answered him, "You are the Christ, the Messiah." And he sternly ordered them not to tell anyone about him. Then Jesus began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, Jesus rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." Jesus called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves, take up their cross, and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father, from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. The text for this morning tells us that Jesus is heading up to Caesarea Philippi, a heathen area, if you will, not a Jewish area. Way north of the Sea of Galilee, probably the most north that Jesus went his entire life. And it is there that Jesus puts forth this question. But before that, we are told that Jesus says to ask this as he is on the way. On the way. Now, I'm not going to put Dex on the spot, but I know Dex knows some Greek because he remembers that word, the way. Hodos, hodos, they are on the way. I want to talk a little bit this morning once again about what it means for Jesus to be on the way. Where is he going? What is the way? And what about us being on the way in the midst of all the challenges that we are facing today? But before we do so, let us pray. On what may now be sown, your blessing, Lord, bestow. For the power is yours alone to make it sprout and grow. As we hear your word for us this day, gracious God, may our hearts and minds be open to receive your word and to carry it with us as we, too, are on the way. remember the story? The dove came down and God said, spoke from the heavens, "This is my beloved Son with whom I am well pleased." And then we have the one command that God the Father gives us in the New Testament. One command. That's the only command that God the Father gave in the New Testament. You remember what it is? Listen to Him. Listen to Jesus. Well, we're going to listen to Jesus today because the text says Jesus began to teach them, that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering. You and I know the rest of the story, don't we? That He's going to go down to Jerusalem, and we know what's going to happen to Him there. We know that He's going to be crucified, but we also know that in 3 days, He's going to rise up. He's going to rise up because, you see, the evil of the world cannot hold down the one who is the Savior of the world. Amen. That's what we need to remember. The Savior is with us as we are on the way. But now you see, Peter wasn't really listening very well, was he? Because he wasn't getting the whole message. It's like the story of that blind man just prior to our text, which we didn't hear about today. But the blind man, you know, he obviously needed healing. He needed to have his vision restored. And so Jesus does that, but it takes two touches. Because after the first, he could only see dimly. It was kind of foggy. And some of us go through life seeing rather dimly. Maybe we all do. We all have questions. Join us on Wednesday morning. There are lots of questions, aren't there, Bob? And Karen, you guys are there every Wednesday. We have lots of questions. And we still do. But we know this, that Jesus is our Lord, and He travels with us according to His word of promise. So Peter, the Bible says, took Jesus aside. Be careful, because Peter does two things. He takes Jesus aside. It's almost like he grabs Jesus by the lapel. How about Jesus? written on a stone in Hallstatt. That's a little beautiful little town in Austria. And there was a stone at the beginning of the pathway leading up to a residence. And it had these words printed on it. And I took a picture. Where are German people here today? No one wants to risk that, I guess. So, well, I tell you what, my German pronunciation, you know, geh nicht vor mir, ich werde dir nicht folgen. Geh nicht hinter mir, ich werde dich nicht führen. Geh einfach neben mir und sieh mein Freude. Go not before me or ahead of me, I may not follow you. Go not behind me, I may not lead you. Just go or walk beside me or next to me and be my friend. People of God, you and I have the privilege of walking together as the children of the Heavenly Father. Indeed, most of us here as members of St. Peter's Lutheran congregation. That is our privilege. And I count on you to be supportive in that walk, in that journey. And I have a suspicion you may count a little bit on me. And that's all good, because God has called us into this fellowship of believers. Has he not? And welcomed us that we might be on the way with one another, loving, caring, supporting each other. That's an awesome blessing, but it's also an awesome responsibility. It means we have to hang in there, even when we don't like the message of where it might be taking us. None of us are enjoying this stressful time in our society, our nation, our world. And it's real easy to criticize. Look at Peter. Criticism is easy and cheap. And so Peter immediately criticizes Jesus. What's not so easy is to remain faithful to God's call, to God's word. The simple word, to love. Well, the psalmist, the first lesson that Sherry read from Isaiah 50, and if you can kind of make a mental and take this home with you, there's a word in Isaiah 50. Jesus says, those who want to save their life will lose it. Those who lose their life for my sake and the gospel will save it. Life, psuche, your soul, that which makes you, you, and me, me. And we are called upon to give it to the Lord, who receives it, who holds it in loving care, and then we can share it with one another. Turn again from your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt well with you. For you have rescued my life. I will walk, this is verse 9, Psalm 116, verse 9. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. May God bless us as we journey together. As we are on the way together in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Now may the peace that passes all understanding keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus on this, what is often rally day in the church, but today and always. Amen. weeks ago, we talked about the Spheros Logos and the hard word and the hard task of getting at our communion element. So make that as ready as you care to. And now I'd like you just to hold that up as we pray God's blessing in the consecration of the elements. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. Gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink of it for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All who hunger and thirst, come. Now the table is ready. And so receive now the body of Christ. This is the body of Christ given for you. May the body of our Lord Jesus the Christ and his precious blood strengthen you and keep you in his grace unto life everlasting.
Amen.
Amen. You can put those the empty container back in the plastic bag and place it in the receptacle at the door on the way out. Lord of life, in the gift of your body and blood, you turn the crumbs of our faith into a feast of salvation. Send us forth into the world with shouts of joy, bearing witness to the abundance of your love in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Now, people of God, and so if you're able and willing to stay, you want to police the grounds join in that effort, that would be awesome. We lost a good man this past week. Earl Hewitt was called home after his journey with cancer, and he fought the good fight. And we are going to celebrate his life this upcoming Saturday. The service will be at 11 o'clock. It will be at Community Church of Ocean Pines. That's on Racetrack Road, 589. The service begins at 11 o'clock. I will have the privilege of presiding at that service. You will be asked to wear your mask, because those are the rules that we are currently following in order to just do our best to stay safe during this very, very challenging time. So come and join us for that time of worship as we remember Earl and certainly give thanks for his life and the life of Jesus, who promises us life everlasting. As we are reminded each week, if you should have any COVID symptoms or are test positive, please let the church office know so we can pray for you, but also so we can let everyone else know what's going on and what needs to be done. I think that's about it. Did I forget anything? For the good of the order, we're good? I think we're good. Okay. Our closing,